Okay, so this is Jay Hawkscott. It's been a long time since I've done a video, and I think things will make sense as to why it's been so long. My old tank I tore down, and I actually donated my tank to a local group here in the Houston area that builds fish tanks for kids with serious illnesses. And my old 135-gallon tank went to a little girl that has cancer, has leukemia. And so it was an older tank. It wasn't worth a whole lot of money, but I thought if I could put a smile on a little girl's face, I thought that was a wonderful use of it. So I donated my old tank and stand to that project. And the reason I did that is because I wasn't going to need the tank anymore. My wife and I have begun construction on a new home, and that's what we're looking at here. This is the new home. So we live in a coastal area, so we live in what's considered an elevated home, and we do that because of hurricanes and high water and stuff like that. Hurricane Ike, we currently live in the same area as we're building, but for instance, Hurricane Ike in our old house, we had about 5.5 feet of water downstairs, and downstairs for us was an entryway and a garage. But so this home is being built similarly. It's actually being considerably higher due to the new flood requirements. But okay, so what I'm showing you here, though, within this house, my wife has graciously given me the approval for a fish tank room. So what you're looking at here is the fish tank room. This opening here, see the walls over here? This is actually a wall to the kitchen. I'm standing in the kitchen. And then this little rectangular layout on the ground will actually be the new fish tank. The new fish tank is going to be 7 feet long by 30 inches front to back by 28 inches height. So it's just going to be over 300 gallons. So I'm significantly increasing the size of my aquarium, and I'm actually going to use a lot of the same equipment I had before. Some of the equipment I had bought previously with the thought that at some point in time I might increase the size, so I oversized stuff. So I'm going to be taxing all that equipment. Here's my fish tank room. Is not very big. If you look, here's the edge of the tank. It's the plywood marks the outside of the tank. So on this part right here, that's the end of the tank. So I've got this little space over here, and then a wall there, and then that's going to be the door into the fish tank room. So I'm kind of changing my plans of my layout here, and I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take and I'm going to put my sink on this wall right here, and then right next to it along this wall I was going to put my water change station, and then maybe put a folding countertop thing that would fold down up over the top of the water change station for my work area. My original plan was to put my sink on the back wall, but there's not a whole lot of room back behind, and if I put I was going to put a workbench along this wall, and if I put the sink was going to go like right here, and then I'd have a workbench along here. But the problem is this isn't real wide. This is what I'm dealing with here is like 3 feet. So if I take a foot away, which is a very narrow workbench and a sink, and I've only got 2 feet back here, and that starts getting kind of difficult to maneuver. And I'm going to have a step stool and stuff like that to get into the tank. So I'm thinking I'm just going to want to leave this whole area back here open so that I can get to my tank, which is there. So another area I have potentially available, I think, is underneath. Here's the stairs that go upstairs. But I'll have underneath here for storage. So I'm gonna have to make use of that as best I can. Again, it's not a huge space, but I'm thankful to have to have the space. I haven't finalized how I'm going to build the room, and so if you've got any suggestions, I'm really open to them. But some of the people I've talked to suggested just to essentially make the room like a shower. And so I want to put a waterproof membrane down, and I do plan to have a floor drain in here as well. And I'm still trying to figure out exactly how I'm going to deal with the climate, the humidity, and all that stuff. I've thought about using one of those portable room air conditioners and sticking it in here to help control some of the humidity and some of the cooling of it. But this room is right smack dab in the middle of the house, so I don't have, it's not an exterior wall, and so I think it'll maintain its temperature pretty well. But if you've got any suggestions on that, I'm more than happy to listen to them. I haven't quite totally figured that out. So, but okay, let me go downstairs and I'll show you some other considerations that we had to take into account for this fish tank room. I'll go down there and I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm downstairs here and you can see how the home is elevated. You can see the water right there. That goes out to the bays and towards Galveston. I'm down south of Houston is where I'm located at. But so when in a hurricane, that water comes up. And in Hurricane Ike, there's actually a railroad bridge right there. And the water was well over that. So that's why this home's so elevated. Now, as you can see, here's the structure that holds up the house. This is the columns and beams that go right down the center of the home. And the standard is two by 12s paired up on both sides. That holds the normal house structure. Now, we come over here. This is where the fish tank room is. These are they're single beams, but they're 5-inch wide, so they're considerably wider. You can see the width of them, and this is right where the fish tank's going to be. The fish tanks will sit basically right on top of these, and we have the engineer design this area of the home to hold 8,000 pounds, which is far more than I will need. But it is designed to hold that. So the fish tank room actually is kind of between these. So it's actually kind of on top of this column and being held by these beams. So, I mean, it's way over engineered to hold that weight. But that was a consideration that we had to take into account. I haven't dealt with the plumbing or the electrical yet. Those are upcoming. But right now I'm just dealing with the structure and the space of the room. So it's kind of an exciting project. We're overwhelmed with all the work on the house, but it's a neat endeavor. So anyways, I think that's pretty much it. I'll try and shoot some more videos as we go along here. And again, if you've got any suggestions for me, I'm really would love to hear what other people have done and other ideas. So, but for now, I guess this is Jayhawk Scott signing out.